take your place. You don't know what you got till it's gone. Know when it's right till it's wrong. It's such a perfect when you had it with you all alone. You broke your heart down with ease. Now I'm picking up every piece. You must be so hard to please. I wish I could say thank you for all the mistakes. Thank you for all of the pain. I guess somebody else's loss is another's gain. I'm saying thank you to the one who let her get away.
How's it going, guys? Welcome to my very first tutorial video. Today, we're going to be going over Vally Amp. This is for a low budget challenge on White Walker's Discord, which I will put the link in the description. This build has 89 structures, and you know, I haven't trap counted, but we'll get to that. Yeah, it's gonna get a better view from back here real quick. I guess the first thing we'll go over is block off. Now, we're gonna go with a diagonal floor. Angled roof. Two Doritos. And two full walls. Okay. On the inside here, we have heels attached. And a reload ceiling electric field. Now this particular reload ceiling electric field happens to be in nature. Now it really doesn't matter as long as anything that can be phased through the wall is killed. So that means try not to use spikes. If possible, use any of these will work. They all have heals. And they don't need to necessarily be one of each. It was just a prime example of, it can be a heals attached Zappo Max. It can be a heals attached wall dynamo. It can even be a heals attached, wall dart. It doesn't really matter as long as they have heals and they can kill. Now, let's see here. Any other this block off. This block off is on Vally Amp, but is more or less for beach. So it's just to stop the huskies from walking through there. And I believe that to be all of our block off. Let's get into the amp build, shall we? Now, for the amplifier, it's your standard assassin design. So make sure you wrap your build in Doritos. Do not use this Dorito. A lot of people will like one here, but what that's going to cause is a smasher is going to walk up this right here and just smack right through it all. So make sure you don't have anything there. It won't pose to be any problem at all. After your Doritos are placed, place all of your arches around the entire top of the amplifier. And as well as your pillars need to be on each one, obviously not here, but each one of them needs to have your pillar. All right, next, this is very important to cut down on the amount of huts that are beating on this wall. Make sure you edit your floor piece. Okay? just like that. That will cause any husk to come here and just walk right in. Okay. Yeah, I think that'll handle that. So let's get on to putting some traps and finishing out this build, shall we? Now, we have some flat pieces on here. That way, if any flingers do happen to throw a husk, they will walk off of it, walk around, and get fucked up. This dino, this dart, will take care of any problems of any husk falling on top of it. These three anti-airs are double range, double reload, heals attached, facing south, and the one up top is 4 damage, 1 heals attached, facing south. And I don't... Oh, and there's another one up there as well. Same one. These sound walls, they are... The one on the left is 4 durability, 1 green reload, heals attached. And this one is... Boom, 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 boom. I'm looking for it. I do apologize. 3 durability, 2 reload effect duration. Now, this wall launcher up against the amplifier's computer is an increased building health, 1 reload, 3 impact. Nope, I apologize. It's 4 impact, 1 reload, increased building health. And then this one is 5 impact, floor pusher. Right there. This one is 4 impact, 1 reload. Right there. And this one is 3 impact, 2 reload. Right here. And we have one angled roof piece, which drops the husks right here. And this one is a double reload, 1 impact. Well, I take it back. It's 2 impact, 1 reload, 3 durability. No. Let's find out. 69? No, you're 70. No, what it did would be that one. It's just reading it wrong. So yes, it is 2 reload, 2 impact, 2 durability. My sincere apologies. And these are just simple little floor spikes to slow them down. It doesn't really matter what kind of floor spikes you have here, but preferably not to do too much damage to them. Wow. That's old. And don't worry about that one. They really don't matter. Alright. Doop, boop, boop, boop. We covered that end. All of those traps. Let's cover this one. This is a double reload tar pit, I believe. Nope, never mind. It's an all durability. Every one of these zappers here should be right here. It's just a simple reload. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 of them. This is for any weird smasher or just any weird husk that wants to walk into the amplifier. You could have a friend standing over there somewhere, or somebody just spawns in on your base, and just anything can happen. So these are just a an insurance policy. Though it's very rare I take any damage to it, but it helps. This right here is a healing Zaplamax. It could be a dino if you would like it to be. This here is if Hus come off of ramp or home base and try to walk towards you, if somehow they were able to make it past this one and this one and try to walk to you, this will take care of them. It's very rare, which is why we have this, but if they do get over here, it just takes care of them so they don't beat this wall piece down. This dart right here on the inside portion is a simple reload. And this one did I up that one to 144 already? Is that why? I believe this one to be this. Reload heals. And this one happens to be right here. Double reload, double damage, increase building health? No, not increase building health, but it's still a double reload into this one instead. Both would actually work. And this one is as well. It's a double reload. 130. No, no, it's not actually. It's crit rate, double crit damage, damage. Nice. And this one, I know is right here. Double reload, triple durability, effect duration, and it is facing this way, so that any husks that freeze into it fall into the dino. No more block off. Cover the tar pit, those. This right here, in the event, 1, 2, 3, 4. In the event that a husk is beating on this, that will get triggered from the Hus walking over here, but it's just that little added piece to make sure that nothing gets stuck beating on this. Some people will put an electric field here, but by having the electric field here, you do a little bit more damage than you want to do to the husks, and this just seems to work out really, really well for them. And that is just your standard 144 with a reload. And there's another one right here as well. And there's another one here. And another one here. Now, in the event that this gets hit after wave 25, I can't really remember which random wave it would be, but it's very highly unlikely. We have this dart to shoot the lobbers and flingers from this direction, though it isn't very necessary, but I like a little overkill. Can't go wrong with that. This is mistakenly the wrong trap, so we're gonna go ahead and fix it by adding a little extra durability. Because it generally gets hit a lot. Obviously, it's its main walking path. This wall dart is another one of those reload wall darts, and that is because a flinger will fling from here. And there's nothing really to injure it to make it continue its walk path forward up here. So it helps out tremendously. And then obviously we have a reload and a non-reload. reload and non-reload. We're using, two reload, two impact durability effect duration, facing the north to pull the flingers into the dinos. Same thing over here. We have a reload and a non-reload. I don't know why I had it in a dino form, but we're just going to switch it out and make it a little bit easier for you guys to understand and see. Come on, heal up. It's absolutely the worst. Now, the UFO part. After you've placed your amplifier, right here on the ramp, on the very corner, place your first tile. And then skip, tile, skip, tile, skip, tile, skip, tile, and so forth and so on. This one right here, in front of the stairs, you're gonna edit like this to allow the lava bomb to smack in the middle of it and not blow up your little tiles. All right, now, obviously we cannot place a tile on top of our stairs, so we place a wall. Same thing here, and same thing here. And this should give you about 2 to 4 leftover pieces on the UFO. Granted, it's overkill. We probably can get rid of a few of them, but sometimes it's best to have a couple of them because your UFO could let some of these go. And I've had the UFO strike them and actually leave a lot of these alone sometimes. And that's really nice by having those extras, because you never know which one you're going to get left over. And it's really nice if you get one of the floor spikes left over. This one is a 77, but it's just a downcrafted version of one of these. But realistically, it was placed there by White Streams himself, so I'm not trying to like take it out. It's like, you know, it's like sentimental to me, but it doesn't need to be anything spectacular. You can use an 89 or a 22 or, well, any of them really, but mainly you just want to use something that doesn't do a lot of damage. And it really helps them out a lot. And I believe that to be it, guys. We have all of our floor pieces down. We went over our wall darts. Our loop. 2 up, floor. 1 down, walls. And they go right down here to the bottom. Now what we did here is we have 2 edited floor pieces to stop the husk from getting inside of the lava. One edited like so. And then up here in the corner, we have one edited like this. And this will force the husk to go around and head towards our ramp. Simple little block off. Wall, floor, ramp, wall. If this ever did get broke down, there's that one last pusher in there just to help push them. But we're going to be slimming that down later in life anyway, because it's been in there for a few years. Making sure they have no access to the lava side. And yeah, this is part of ramp, and that is part of lava. Okay, Let's go ahead and hop up for one last more look-see, and that should be all. Doo doo doo. Kitty kitty. Meow meow meow. Yeah. Covered that one. Just want to make sure I did all the covering. And we did. There you guys go. Welcome to my very first tutorial video. My low budget Vally amplifier. You guys have yourself a wonderful and fantastic day. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.